Lion. Brought to you by Kellogg's, the folks who give you the widest choice of cereals in the whole wide world. All the great grains in the forms you like best. Yours from Kellogg's of Battle Creek. Now let's all play What's My Line?
And now let's meet our award-winning What's My Line panel. First, the delightful star of stage and television, Miss Arlene Francis.
And now, here he is. He's the master of my fate. He's the captain of my soul. He's the man that I married, Mr. Martin Gabel.
On my left, a rare beauty, the star of 20th Century Fox's upcoming film, Fraulein, Miss Donna Winter.
Thank you, Martin, and for the privilege of being here tonight. And it's my pleasure to introduce a wonderful person, someone I met 3 years ago at Anne Shelley's house on the coast and never guessed that I would be here with him on What's My Line one day. Mr. Bennett, sir.
Well, our wandering boy, John Daly, is in Tokyo tonight, so batting from again is that well-known critic and connoisseur of letters, Mr. Clifton Fadiman.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to What's My Line. You remember last week we had, as one of our contestants, a very charming young lady, Mrs. Patterson, whose occupation is being shot out of a cannon at the Ringling Brothers Circus. Well, I told you I was going to go to the circus to see her shot out of a cannon. I did go yesterday, and she was shot out of a cannon. And as she went by, rather rapidly, she said, "Give my best to What's My Line." I thought she'd like to. Also, you remember that I told you that I was going to take 12 children about the age of 6 to the circus, and I did so via the New Haven Railroad. And I would like to report that on this trip, I personally took orders for and delivered 87 drinks of water in paper cups, with the results that you might expect, and it was a very short trip, too. Well, as Bennett said, this is my second week in John Daly's shoes, and even though I feel they're a little too big for me, I'm enjoying the experience. However, I know that you'll all be glad to know that John will be back with us next week, having convinced himself by his news flight that the world is actually round. That same world is full of interesting occupations and odd jobs, and week after week, What's My Line comes up with them, sometimes baffling our panel and sometimes not. There'll be a mystery guest a little later on in the show, and we'll meet our first contestant in just 1 minute. Okay, panel, are you ready? Yes. May we have our first contestant? Will you sign in, please? That's Father, Hugh, Michael, Bea, is that right?
I'm from Grand Rapids, Michigan.
Oh, it's a fine town. I remember it very well. It's one of the many towns that Bennett spoke of.
Got friends.
All your friends out here. You know our panel, Father? Father
Bayon? I have to know.
Come over and sit down beside me.
We'll see if we can get on with this game.
Thank you, Mr. Bennett.
Now, you understand how to play this game, Father Bayon, in case I make my usual errors, in case Arlene forgets to correct me. Now, panel, it is obvious what Father Bain's noble profession is, from his costume. But he has another occupation. Otherwise, he wouldn't be on the show. All right, let's show the audience in the theater and at home what your occupation is. Okay, I am instructed to tell you that Father Bain is salaried. And we'll start with the lovely Arlene Francis this evening.
Well, I was just going to say that I think the only question I shouldn't ask was whether you worked for a profit-making organization.
I think you may ask any legitimate question.
Well, this extracurricular work you do, Father, is it a service?
Yes, Miss Francis, it is.
Does it require pencil and paper work?
I use a typewriter, if that helps any.
No, but if it helps you.
Yes or no, I should say, right?
Well, would you include typewriter in your...
I would prefer it.
All right. In that case, the answer would be yes.
Is there any product whatsoever involved in what you do, Father?
No, Miss Francis, there is not.
That's one down, a nine to go, and passes us on to Martin Gabel, the captain of her fate, or of her soul. I forget which one it is.
I'm not sure myself now. Both.
I am.
Father, is this work that you do connected with your basic occupation?
It is, Mr. Gabel.
When it was said that you were salaried, do you receive a salary for this work in addition to your fundamental income?
Yes or no? Well, the idea here is, of course, that most priests receive a basic salary,
yes,
and whatever they're told to do, they do, and the salary stays the same.
Yes, quite. Well, that's what I meant.
Yes.
Is it more connected with youth than adults?
No, not necessarily.
That's two down and eight to go, Miss Wynte. How about you?
Are your services directed to both men and women?
They are, Miss Wynte. Mm-hmm.
And are these people better off for what you do?
Well, if they're not, I'm wasting an awful lot of time.
Foolish question.
I think in order to save the blushes of Father Bain, that the answer to that is yes, they are better off.
Thank you. Hope. Is your work educational?
It could be so classified, I think.
Could be. Do you need special training apart from...
If you mean in the sense of having gone to a school or getting a degree or something of that sort, Miss Wynte, would your answer not be no, Father?
I think for the, in our term of reference, as John Daly's always saying...
Would you like to sit over here, Father? No, the answer would be...
I would say no.
The answer would be no.
They will hang us if we
no,
say...
No, what I meant was, well, has it anything to do with then something other than your calling as a priest?
Other than the fact that I am a priest?
Yes.
Yes, I think we would say
that. I think so, but I think we'd have to say no to the previous.
Well, all right.
Three down, seven to go, and pass.
Miss Wynte catches on fast.
Father Bain, would you say that this extracurricular work in which you're engaged has a cultural aspect?
One moment. I think so, Mr. Cerf, yes.
You remember, Mr. Cerf, I'm beginning to learn this game myself, but one of the questions previously asked was, did it have any educational effect? The answer of the father to that was yes. If it had an educational effect, it would have a cultural
not
one, too.
Necessarily. Father Bain might teach people to grow carrots, which would be educational but not be cultural.
I think growing carrots... Well, it may not be cultural, but there's certainly a good deal of cultivation involved in carrots.
I don't even like carrots.
Let's go back. The answer is yes to that. And you may now continue with your
question. Would this special work, Father Bain, have anything to do with either books or plays or pictures?
No, I'm afraid it would not.
That
sir.
Is four down and six to go, passing us over to Miss Francis.
Would married people come to you for your services? If they married young, I presume.
Well, here we go. Just a moment. We'll be right back.
The answer, strictly speaking, as John would say, the answer to that question, if we are to take it literally, is no. Married people would not come to the father for his services. That's five down and five to go. We're about halfway.
I'm a little disappointed in you, Miss Francis. I once appeared on one of your shows, and you don't remember me at all.
I don't remember that you appeared on one of my shows, and I apologize for that, Father, and I'll appear on any of yours.
Good Well, isn't it nice that you two meet again, Mr.
Yes, Wynte? Yes.
I do have an idea.
Mr. Gabel.
Is this work of yours, this secondary work of yours, done more outdoors than indoors?
No, it is not, Mr. Gabel.
That is six down and four to go. Miss Wynte.
Does anybody want a conference, or are you on something?
Miss Wynte, you may confer.
No, I'm on absolutely nothing. Please. Yes.
May we have a conference for just a minute?
Yes, indeed. 15 seconds.
Since he doesn't talk to married people, maybe he talks to people before they get married and has a sort of marriage counseling.
Oh, it isn't. I can tell by the audience.
You remember.
It might have something.
And I said, you remember I said, Arlene, that I had to take your question very literally and give it a no answer. Now, Miss Wynte.
Well, then, Mr. Cerf's helped. Do you have anything to do with babies?
With babies? I think
with babies?
Babies.
Yes. No, I'm sorry, Miss Wynte.
No married people.
Oh, there's nothing to be sorry about, Father. A lot of people have nothing to do with babies. The answer is no, Miss Wynte. That's seven down and three to go.
Father Bain, do you have anything to do with teaching people something aside from the doctrines of the church?
No, I don't think so, Mr.
You don't.
Well, I'm afraid, Bennett, we're all on the wrong track. We'll give lose all the rest of the money, and I must tell you now that the Reverend Hugh Michael Bayon is a disc jockey. It's a little unusual to combine these two professions. How did you happen to get into this somewhat competitive business?
Well, I do a television show out home for WOOD, plug, and some friends of mine set up a new radio station, WGHN, plug. Now I can go home now, you see. And they wanted me to come down and do the radio version of the television. I thought, well, 15 minutes of straight talk on radio is not exactly my idea of top programming, unless you've got a man like Mr. Fadiman, which I am not.
Thank you, sir.
And they only make Monsignor Bishop Sheens once in a great while. So we decided to make it fit radio's own type of programming and make it a music show. And I find now in a survey we're making for the Catholic Broadcasters Association convention that there are three of us doing it. Father Moore in Steubenville is doing religious music, and Monsignor Patrick Smith in Santa Fe is doing it with Spanish South American music.
Well, maybe there's a real affinity, Father, between disc jockeyism and your noble profession.
May I ask one question, Mr. Diamond, Father Bain?
Yes,
I'd be interested to know, Father, what percentage of rock and roll you play on your...
Exactly program? Zero.
Well, good for you.
And now, may we have our next contestant. Will you sign in, please? Roy Rogers. We will make no jokes. Rogers, no relation, I assume. And where are you from?
Durham and Greensboro, North Carolina.
Durham and Greensboro?
And Greensboro.
Are you a split personality? You divide yourself between these two?
Probably.
Durham's where the cigarettes come from.
That's right.
And Greensboro's where half of you comes from.
Mm-hmm.
Meet the panel over there and then follow me over to the desk, will you? Now, you know how to play this game?
Yes, I do.
Rogers, good enough. Let's show the audience in the theater and at home just what your occupation is. Mr. Rogers is self-employed, and we'll start with, may we, Donna Wynte.
It's a risk, but we may.
No risk for us.
Mr. Rogers, do you deal in services?
Yes, I do.
Could I benefit from your services?
Yeah, possibly, yes.
Yes.
You want to work a little closer
possibly,
to the mic?
Possibly, yes.
Do you deal with... women, rather, more than with men?
Yes.
Yes. Do these women come to you for this
yes.
service? Do they come to a special place? Are you in any...
Yes.
Yes.
Why don't you go into this as a regular thing, Miss Wynte, instead of wasting your time and those other things you do?
Do you touch them?
Yes.
Yes. Do you wear a special uniform for what you do, or a special garb?
No.
No.
That's one down and nine to go, but I think Miss Wynte has opened up, obviously, a field, Mr. Cerf, that now cultivate.
Mr. Rogers, since you were speaking barely above a whisker, I didn't quite hear... I didn't quite hear where you said you came from. Was Greensboro, North Carolina?
Greensboro and Durham.
And Durham.
Yes.
Well, now there are two colleges there. There's a women's college in Greensboro and Duke and Durham.
That's right.
Does your work have anything to do, possibly, with the students of either of those colleges?
Specifically to do with them?
Well, I would say related to tutoring them or something of that sort.
Yes, as against any other group of human beings.
That's a no. I see.
No, that would be no. That's two down and eight to go. I'm getting the hang of this thing. All right, Arlene.
He said he touched them, Bennett.
Yes, well, he did.
Never, Bennett.
Never teaches, never touch. Do women improved after they've been to see you?
Yes.
Is there something in your treatment or your work that beautifies them in some way?
Yes.
Would you have a beauty salon or a massage salon of some kind?
Of some kind? I mean, of that category?
Oh, well, if you're going to be so specific, I mean, like a barbershop or a beauty salon or a Turkish bath. Yes?
Yes. Yes. Keep it going.
Somebody applaud the Turkish bath. I'm for them, too.
Well, we'll exclude Turkish
bath. Somebody will send you in the mail, Ali.
Well, shall I take one of those categories?
Go ahead.
Let's take the Turkish bath, as long as somebody applauded. It's the wrong one, but then, is it?
No.
No, well, that's three down and seven to go.
You have a barbershop, Mr. Rogers?
No.
That is four down and six to go, Miss Wynte.
Yes, but it could be a massage, you know, it could be a massage. Well, all right, beauty parlor.
Yes.
That is
very
right.
Good.
Yes.
Very
beauty
good.
Beauty parlor,
Mr.
is correct. Actually, Mr. Rogers has a beauty parlor, and specifically, he is a hairdresser. Is that correct, Mr. Rogers?
Hairstylist.
Hairstylist, I beg your pardon. Well, I always put
like
my foot into it.
I certainly like the way you've done your own, Mr. Rogers.
Thank you. I think it's only my curiosity.
Is that a horse, Mr. Rogers?
Beg your pardon, Mr. Gabel?
Is Mr. Rogers a horse?
No. Just tell us, can you tell us briefly why you have that beard?
Greensboro is having a 150-year celebration, the sesquicentennial.
Oh, yes.
So most of the men are growing beards.
And that's all there is to that, in case you wanted to know.
Wait till Remington Rand finds out about that.
He can practice on himself. Good to have you with us, Mr. Rogers. You said you bought the time. We'll meet tonight's mystery guest in just a moment, but first, here's a word from our alternate sponsor. We come now to our mystery celebrity, and during this interval, I assume that you've put on your blindfolds, or that Miss Wynte and Mr. Cerf are now about to put them on. Very pretty the girls do look, even behind those blindfolds. Okay, will you come in, mystery challenger, and sign in, please? Okay, the rules are a little different here. They get just one chance apiece, and I think we'll start with Bennett, sir, shall we?
Well, just Bennett? To get this into the right or wrong groove quickly, are you a representative of the entertainment industry?
Yes.
Have you appeared in the... Pardon me.
Go ahead, pass.
Have you appeared in the theater?
Mas o menos.
What was
it? Mas o menos, eh? You'll have to explain that to the illiterate to your left.
More or less.
More or less, that means.
Have you appeared in musical shows?
See,
that means yes, too. I'm learning more languages than I can handle. Miss Wynte.
Do you appear on television? See.
Mr. Sir.
Have you ever been... or spent any considerable amount of time in Mexico?
No.
All right, that's one down and nine to go, Arlene.
Are you doing a television show of your own?
Of her own.
Más o menos.
Is that
After consultation, I will have to say that the literal answer to that question is no. She does not have a television show of her own. Two down, eight to go, Mr. Gabel.
Are you now appearing in a Broadway show?
In a Broadway show?
No.
No, three down and seven to go.
Do you appear frequently as a guest artist on television?
I have to answer that literally.
No.
No is the answer. Four down and six to go, Mr. Cerf.
Well, are you... You haven't got a television show of your own, but might it be said that you are a member of a cast, a regular cast, that does appear in a regularly scheduled television show?
See.
Yes, the literal answer to that is that she is a member of the entire cast of a television show. That passes us back to Miss Frances.
Is that a musical... My voice is changing. Is that a musical show?
No.
No, five down and five to go. We're halfway through our cards. Mr. Gabel.
Is it a situation comedy show?
At times.
At times.
Is it meant to be, I should say?
I don't...
No.
I think on the whole the answer would be no
on
to that.
Whole,
don't
yes.
you? That is six no. down and four to go. We ought to tie this up. Miss Wynte.
Are you part of a panel show? No.
That is seven down, three to go. Maybe you're glad of it, too. Mr. Sird.
In the show in which you appeared, do there sometimes enter cowboys and Indians with guns and sheriffs and things?
No, thank heaven.
Well, eight down and two to go. Arlene.
Have you appeared in any nightclubs or hotel rooms?
I think we understand what Miss Frances means.
Well, which floor?
The answer to that would be yes,
yes.
Surely. All right, Mr. Gable. And Miss, we ought to be able to get it now.
Since my wife has told me she knows who it is, and when she says she knows, she usually knows.
No, I don't. After all, I didn't know about Father Bean, but I do have an idea.
Well, tell me, and I will relay it.
I think it may be Jane Powell.
Are you Jane Powell?
Yes.
Of course, Miss Powell is currently appearing at the Plaza, is it not?
Yes, sir. I had no idea that I was such a mystery to...
Well, Miss Powell said she more or less was in the movie.
Yes.
Yeah,
we think of you as more.
Well, they don't make musicals too often now, you see.
How many talents? You have a dramatic show, too, don't you? You appear very often in a...
Yes, I have.
Aren't you going to be on this panel next week, Miss Powell?
I wish I were, Mr. Cerf, but I am unable to attend.
Oh,
but I'm looking forward to the next invitation.
Our loss. What are you going to do after the Persian Room engagement ends?
Well, I'm going to Dallas, Texas, as a matter of fact, to appear in Oklahoma. So
oh,
I'm looking
good
forward
enough.
To that. A great
we're
deal.
All looking forward to it. Congratulations. Hope you have a fine time down in... Is it Dallas?
Yes, Dallas.
It's a big town.
Well, thank you very much. I'm looking forward to it.
Good to have you with
good
us.
Night.
We'll be back after this word from our sponsor. We'd like to thank Dana Wynte for gracing our panel tonight with her wit and her beauty.
Thanks.
And I announce again that John Daly, perhaps to the relief of many of you, will be back next week. I've been moderator for 2 weeks. I've enjoyed it enormously. I think I should thank both the panel and this audience for your patience and courtesy. And now this is Clifton Fadiman saying good night, Arlene.
Good night, Clifton, and you have done honor to the chair. We've been very lucky to have you.
Yeah.
And, Martin, I may say the same for you. Good night, dear.
Good night. And good night, Donna. You were wonderful.
Good night, Martin. Thank you so much. Good night, Bennett.
Thank heaven for pretty girls. Good night, Kev. Great to have
you. Good night, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you for being on What's My Life.
For the 12 games of Christmas GSN gave to me. Card sharkers sharking, super passwords passing, Dawson Desi doing, Alan Heidi hosting 5 days a week. 4 miming stars, 3 of hearts, 2 Mrs. Claus, and 1 Charles Nelson Riley.
Celebrate the season with 12 days of classic holiday episodes from your favorite shows. The 12 Games of Christmas on GSN Live, tomorrow at 1 p.m. 12 Central.